fourth People's Health Assembly is being organized in Dhaka, Bangladesh, in the background of a global health crisis that is characterized by inequities related to a range of social determinants of health and in access to health services within countries and between countries. In large measure, the poor and the vulnerable are being pushed further to the margins due to pitifully inadequate measures to address the social determinants of health. They are also denied access to quality health services as a consequence of unfair economic structures and social conditions that lock people into poverty and ill health.
After 4 decades of that experience of unleashed capitalism, and in particular, more recently, the financialized capitalism that has expanded the inequalities that we've seen, there is a growing recognition that the ideology and the policies have failed.
In recent years, austerity measures in both the Global South and the North have further compromised access, often as a consequence of the dismantling of public services and the increasing reliance on private provision of healthcare.
Think of the word social murder. So Engels, when he was looking at the early days of the Industrial Revolution, said the class which at present holds social and political control places hundreds of proletarians in such a position that they inevitably meet a too early and unnatural death. So it seems to me, when you think of that pattern of wealth, when you think of the way corporations work, social murder is happening across the world today.
The achievement of universal and secure access to comprehensive healthcare services can be a reality only through the revitalization of comprehensive primary healthcare, as envisioned in the Alma Ata Declaration of 1978. Health and healthcare in different regions face additional challenges brought on by the effects of climate change and by the deteriorating social and political environment, such as the massive humanitarian crisis brought on by a rise in forced migrations.
These people arrived malnourished, in shock, and many with bullet injuries. Majority were women and children, and the women had suffered multiple rape. Every woman I spoke to in September 2017, soon after the major exodus or influx from this end, every woman I spoke to spoke of multiple rape. Not once, at least twice, some maybe 4 times, 5 times.
The promises held out by the Sustainable Development Goals need to be questioned, given that these goals, many of them laudable, are proposed to be attained by the same neoliberal model of development and economic growth that has pushed the globe to the brink of multiple crises, social, political, ecological, and economic.
Intersectoral action on the social determination of ill health is extremely important. In the 10 fast-track countries, of which Bangladesh is one, in reaching MDG 4, over 50% of health improvement comes from actions outside of the health sector. Some analysts have shown that if there is no change in the current economic paradigm, it will take 207 years to achieve the SDGs, and we will need 3.4 planet Earths.
The Fourth People's Health Assembly will draw on civil society organizations and networks, social movements, academia, and other actors from around the globe.
Trade unions play a key role in the achievement of the health for all policies, because you have to realize is that it is the health workers who are providing the services to the population. And so if we are going to realize what we call health for all, health workers must be brought on board. Our services must be provided to all people without border, and not just certain things are available for certain people who have certain conditions that are of interest to certain donors. Whilst other people come to the same facility, they come to you for care, and they cannot get the care because those things are not available.
to enhance the capacity of health civil society activists to engage with and intervene in policy-making process, to monitor and drive policy implementation, and to ensure accountability in the functioning of health systems.
We are still facing inequalities in access to health care, and we are trying to make a case our dialogue with the parliamentarians, with the government officials, to reduce and to mitigate the impact of some of the policies of the government which are eroding the constitutional right to health.
PHA4 provides a unique space for strengthening solidarity, sharing experiences, mutual learning, and joint strategizing for future actions.
In PHA, we have raised our awareness on health issues. We have known that health is for all, and not only for those who have money.
Amandla.
Health for all. We want health for all now.